I don't agree with you pagdating dyan. Kasi talaga nung nagpa-practice ako, nakikita ko na kulang ha. Hindi, marami silang inaangal dyan. Kaya nga siguro ngayon eh, tahimik sila eh. Well, ganito po yun. So, dyan pa lang tayo sa pondo. Kasi hinaalam ko kung saan galing yung pondo ng Land Cruiser. Eh. Dahil sa pag-purchase nyo, ang first step, kailangan may pondo. Okay po. Tapos, sinabi nyo, sinama nyo yan sa annual procurement plan. Pero hindi Land Cruiser ang sinama nyo sa annual procurement plan. Ang nilagay nyo doon, 6 million para sa opisina ni Chief Justice, right?
Yes,
one vehicle. Yes, bakit po 6 million ang nilagay nyo at hindi presyo lang sana ng ordinaryong kotse? O, kagaya ng ibang justices na Camry lang o Fortuner ang sasakyan.
Because there was a prior directive to me po that we will have to consider the vehicle that should be given to the Chief Justice. So there was already an instruction, or if not, one of the members of the committee, of the Procurement Planning Committee, who is from the Office of the Chief Justice.
Will you please speak louder?
One of the members of the Procurement Planning Committee is from the Office of the Chief Justice, who happens to be my vice chair. So, in effect...
What's the name?
Attorney Michael Ocampo po.
Okay.
So, okay. Can I explain how we do the procurement plan po?
Yes, please. Paano nyo nilagay yun?
When we prepare the procurement plan, usually we issue letters beginning probably within the period of July to September. We ask the different offices of the court to submit to us, to the Procurement Planning Committee, what are their needs or what do they need for the incoming year. And since 2014 up to 2016, the procurement of a vehicle of the Chief Justice has always been included, simply because when she was appointed as Chief Justice, she never requested as one. So, but just the same, in deference to her and by reason of her stature, we have to see to it that there is also an amount allotted for her in the procurement of a vehicle. So we had to ask the office of the end user what vehicle would she prefer in the event that we are to procure a vehicle from the end user. And it was them who said that it's a Land Cruiser po.
So, bago pa lang talaga, Land Cruiser na ang instructions na bilhin. Diba? Yun ang nilagay nyo sa APP nyo eh. So, prior to bidding, prior to all the requests that will be made, ang instructions sa inyo, bumili ng Land Cruiser. Okay ba? Yun po bang sinasabi nyo?
No, Your Honor.
Sasabi mo lang, Land Cruiser ang preference nila eh. Sabi nyo, si Attorney Mike ang nagsabi sa inyo na Land Cruiser ang preference nila.
Just the amount, Your Honor, as to the amount that
sinabi mo, Land Cruiser eh.
Not,
sinabi mo, Land Cruiser. Binabago mo ba yung statement mo?
Prior to the Land Cruiser, that amount is not allotted only for a Land Cruiser. Initially, there was an initial request, not only a Land Cruiser. It was only after there was a failure of bidding that we had to recommend for a Land Cruiser.
When pag may instructions sa Land Cruiser ang bibilin beforehand, papasok na yan sa Republic Act 3019. Influencing o kaya persuading a lower officer to enter into a wrong contract. Sa umpisa pa lang, sinasabi na sa inyo, may instructions of Office of the Speaker, Office of the Chief Justice, na ang bibilhin, Land Cruiser. So branding yun. Papasok po yan sa graft and corruption. Yung Procurement Act kasi, pag hindi nyo sinunod yan, ang kakambal na violation nyo, yung graft and corruption. Kaya nga, ngayon po, dahil dito, nakikita natin na predetermined na pala na Land Cruiser ang bibilhin, may problema tayo kasi branding yon in violation of Section 18 of the Procurement Act.